Maybe say some minutes to 6 a.m. because the program starts 6 a.m. in the morning. We go to the chapel, we start meditation, and at 6:30 we have mass plus the morning prayers. Finished mass, we go for breakfast and we prepare ourselves to go to school, which is like a 20 minutes walk from our friary to our college in Tangaza. And so after the morning preparations, we go to Tangaza. Some prefer to go by bicycle, some they walk on foot. But coming to Tangaza has opened another horizon, because just 150 is a number of just like 1 year, because each year has three streams and we do 4 years, so we are approximately, just theological students, we are about 1,000. And these are people from many, many parts of the world.
We are in Langata, Nairobi, Kenya. This is a Franciscan house called the St. Anthony Friary. This house started in 2001. Then it hosts students going to the university for theology. For the time being, we are having 16 students coming from 10 different countries. We have many different nationalities in the house under the same roof. So it's a challenge also ourselves as formators to deal with all those different cultures. Huh? As the running of this house concern also, from a year ago now, we have gotten a hostel that the province has established here, which is run, in fact, by this house. And it is helping in such a way that at least for the time being, we can pay the bill of electricity, monthly bill of the electricity of the house, with the money which is given.
I became a friar because from the beginning, early, still very early in childhood, I really wanted to become a priest. Lastly, I made up my mind that I want to join the real friars, the OFM. A Franciscan way of life helps me to encounter Jesus, I think, in a real and practical way. I would say that being a friar is being authentic. I was really attracted to that kind of simplicity and the openness to people that Francis shared. You are more open to life realities and encountering especially the weak and the poor, and working with them and bringing joy to them and not running away.
Someone come to read his books and find the places he feel comfortable. Focus is at the youth sometime. When you look at the way the youth live, they need some time help. And another thing which I'm interested in is just the like the sick, for the sick where they are. And sometimes I feel that when they are just there, suffering, nobody is going there, they feel that they are rejected a bit.
Do all together the cleaning of our house, especially on weekends. And then apart from that, we also do ourselves the cooking on weekends.
I'm from Kenya, specifically in Nakuru Diocese. We do a washing, cooking, studies, going to the garden also. And at times on Tuesday and Thursday we go for sports.
My name is Brother Victor Hundayezu. His name in Kinyarwanda is I Love Jesus, if you translate it in Kinyarwanda. I'm on to Juan. I'm trying my best to find out how I can, you know, nurture myself in theological studies. That maybe in the future it can help me and help others, the surrounding, my neighbors and the society at large.
Franciscan life is, which has attracted me, is good. It's humility, simplicity, and way of following God. So the path I have followed is the one I have chosen.
I am a master of students for brothers doing their theology at Tangaza College. Now, these brothers are from different countries. In our formation, we do our best to make sure that they grow in a spirit of being able to be there for other people. And so it's part of our formation. We have a lot of slums around. And some go to Kibera slums, some visit the sick and talk to them and listen to them. But now in our formation, we are telling them to kind of forget themselves somehow for the sake of being there for others. So that is challenging. It is a process. You can see that their hearts are willing, but you know, realistically speaking, it's not so easy. It's challenging. We see a lot of selfishness. Everybody's busy struggling for themselves. But at the same time, we see that there is need for people who can be there for those who are not in position to help themselves. And so our aim is to make sure that we come up with young men, Franciscans, who can grow in the spirit of really being there for others. And apart from spirituality, but we also see the need of, you know, young men who can help.
Our life here in Africa is a life where we want to invest more on the value of Franciscan life. And we believe that the gospel values are essential for the development of this country. Let us think, one of the big stigma here in Africa are civil wars. And if we can help people to be instrument of peace, if we can help people to invest more in dialogue than in wars, if we can help people to protest, but in a peaceful way, and if we can help also the institutions to give possibility to the poorest one, to the one they don't have possibility to achieve their goal, they don't have dignity, to give much more space to their action, political action, for these people. That is why also in our areas we try to be involved so much with health and with social entities. And we have postulants that for 2 years they are in Mwanza, Tanzania. After they go for 1 year of novitiate in Uganda, and from Uganda they go in Zambia for philosophy, and after Zambia they come in Nairobi for theology. So for me it's 10 years, because we don't form them only from a point of view of religious, because all our friars, because we are in this area of the world, there is not so much development, they do a lot of social worker. Normally in the Franciscan, for us Franciscan, the people of where we are working, they support us with their offerings. But as you can see here in Africa, the local people, because we choose to be in rural area, they're not able to support our studies. That is why we are obliged to ask help to many people around the world. First of all, our Franciscan brother in different provinces in Europe, in America, in Australia, and after all organizations, they are willing to help us.
Baba yetu uliye mbinguni, jina lako litukuzwe, ufalme wako ufike, utakalo lifanyike duniani kama mbinguni. Utupe leo mkate wetu wa kila siku, utusamehe makosa yetu kama tunavyosamehe sisi
wakosa. Nguvu yangu Bwana
Amen.
Azamala mi zabarama, parama.